So y'all, we're back in the video, man. On Reach to Get 20, y'all. Reach to Get 20, episode 29. Let's go to 2, y'all. It's sweet, boy. So we're gonna get the Hulk show, bro. We're gonna get this team on show 21, so it's sweet, yo. Let's go to tweet. Let's go to tweet. We're in 28 game week streak, y'all. Back to 29 game week streak. Yo, bro, this is Molly, my crew, yo. Yo, bro, I put the code on 10 minutes. So, yeah. Playing against the Hulk show on our home court.
And the Hawks with a confident look as they go into the arena earlier on, looking for a win on the road. And the game arrivals, sponsored by... And as we approach the new season, some new talent making the most of their opportunity in the league. Let's check out the race for Rookie of the Year. Some great young players. Well, you look at Jay, there hasn't been many times where he's played like a rookie as he's come in and done whatever's asked of him. That's why he's our number five.
And at number five in the rankings, it wouldn't be out of the question for him to make a run at that top spot here in the last half of the season.
Not at all. His talent is right on par with any of those guys ahead of him right now in the rookie rankings.
A look at Atlanta's opening lineup. Hunter at the three with Collins at the four. Young and Herter make up the back. And it's Len in at the seven. And for the Nets, we've got DeAndre Jordan. Smooth out there with Prez. Then there's Jay. And it's James in at the three, the small forward. And Brent, many consider Trae Young the first product of the Steph Curry generation. He grew up in the age of the three-point shot.
I think that's pretty fair. He said he recorded all of Steph Curry's games. He studied them, tried to see where Steph was gaining some advantage, and that balance of his shooting and his playmaking, then moving without the ball, you can see all of those sort of attributes that are coming out of Trae Young, courtesy of Steph Curry.
And even with the shift from Budenholzer to Pierce, the Hawks continue to rely on the three as much as any team.
No doubt about it. I think the front office still accentuating the fact that they want to find some floor spacers after that 19th pick in John Collins, a guy that can rim run and protect the middle. Lightning.
That was incredible.
It's too much. It's just too much.
His teammates are falling all over each other. Look at him.
If you're the other team, you got to take that personally. Don't let them get the best of you.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hawks. They put up a nice win against Utah last time out.
And the difference in that one, the efficiency from range. They really focused on getting good looks.
It looked like the directive in that game was that they wanted to attack, and all that work that they put in on the perimeter turned into a big night from deep.
Here's Smooth, and he drops in the layup off the glass. Smooth's got 10 points in the game.
This quarter belongs to him, and that's how you do it when you're out in front. Don't play it safe. Keep that momentum going.
Young's shot is off.
Is it getting cold in here, Kevin? This is a tough one. Crucial that he starts to work a little harder for a higher percentage shot.
And he lays in the alley-oop.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
Yeah, the bully ball tonight has paid dividends. Highly effective down there with the physical play.
Now about 2 minutes gone here in the first quarter. They need this. And no good. And it's the Nets taking it the other way.
So far, the team just 1 of 5 in that rim shrinking.
Gets the three-pointer to fall.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Oh, yeah.
Excellent all-around performance so far, hence the big lead.
Well, if I was baking up a lead, I'd add two ingredients. One would be playing smart. The other one, playing selfless. They've done that tonight. Serve it up.
And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for him.
The most positive thing about his last 10 games, the work on defense. His mindset has become very aggressive. The steals are up, and he's becoming a big factor.
And
the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Halfway through the season, Brent, as a team, are you still discovering new ways to win?
Yeah, I would say if you had a set of encyclopedias, when you get to around January, you should be in the MN section, Kevin. So, do people know what encyclopedias are?
But I can picture my mind. I know exactly what you're saying.
So from that point on in the season, you have a great foundation to build on, and there's a lot of things that you can do that are just slight wrinkles to what it is you already do, and that's the great thing for coaches is to challenge the players to see how far through that encyclopedia we can go. What letter can we get to in the alphabet by the end of the year?
The Hawks trail by 17. To halt the run, and it's denied.
Oh, boy. Oh, boy.
Here's Smooth, defended by Young. To the middle. To the left side wing. Here's Smooth. The shot will not fall. So Atlanta will take it the other way. The 19-foot shot. Still a very tough night shooting for him. That makes him 1 for 8 now. Count it, and he's now 8 of 9 from the floor.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Young with no one around. Again, Young missing.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Passes it to Jay. Nice ball movement by Brooklyn. Gets number 9 to fall. He's only taken 10 shots.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Young dishes the land. From outside the arc. Another miss by Young.
Well, that's a shot right there. He's going to hit 9 times out of 10. We just saw the 10% he doesn't make.
Here's Smooth. Oh!
Got it. Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, if you walked in at any point during this game to watch 5 minutes of play, one team played harder. We know who that was.
Young from outside. And once again off the mark by Atlanta.
If he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
Count the basket. And that's now 25 points for Smooth.
Unwilling to let up even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
Yeah, he's the guy that you want to go to right now trying to put this one away. Yeah, better than giving up the layup, you want to go in there and use the hard foul. They did it there. That's aggressive attitude defensively.
Collins, good.
Shooters tend to be hungry, but this time Herter finds an open teammate.
Nets leading by 23. Here's Smooth. Power down with both hands.
And when the score is as lopsided as it is, and you can see they smell blood in the water, my man is going for the jugular.
And here's Young. He'll bring it up for Atlanta. Looking to get back on track here. He lays it in. Young's got his second bucket.
Such a precise player. When Young notices those kind of openings, he definitely is looking to attack.
Did you just see what I saw? I mean, that move was out of this world.
Executed, don't you think, to perfection, Greg. I mean, he had the rim in his sights and was not going to be stopped. No good with the triple.
Well, it isn't for a lack of effort when it comes to getting up the three-pointers, but not much to show for. He's going to lose the green light here very early in this game if this keeps up.
Jay, they get it back. Here's James, and contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Alex Len picks one up. The Nets shooting their third and fourth free throw shots of the night. Free throw good, James. You know, Brent, how candid can players be in their answers in the post-game interviews about what has happened or what they're feeling at that time? In other words, is there a danger to being too honest as a player?
There could be, Kevin. I mean, anytime you express some of your vulnerabilities, and if it's done at the right time, somebody's going to take advantage of it. What we've seen over the past couple years is, forget about when it is that the media is asking you questions. Most players are taking it to their social media accounts where they're able to get the message out without being baited by somebody with regards to a question. They can expound on whatever it is that they're feeling at that time, and that helps them to control the messaging a little bit more. And I think that trend is going to continue and continue to grow.
Turner finds Parker. Stolen by Allen. Here's Smooth. Boy, he was something else against San Antonio.
Defense better tighten up on the mid-range. They're much, much tighter. You expect him to make every single one of those.
By himself. Oh, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
Well, there you go. One team operating on all cylinders at both ends. Steals, fast break buckets, and the other team in scramble mode.
Ball's knocked loose. In transition, here come the Nets. And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
They start that play with aggressive defense, finish with aggressive offense.
Well, a lot of times coaches will tell you that if you play great defense, you're going to get a reward, a good possession all the way around.
Wow, we are going to remember that one for a while.
I know I will, Greg. That was special. That was really special. And taking care of the ball has been a problem for them.
That's something they've got to fix. While the defense has been good, a lot of these turnovers have been unforced.
And here's Mirotić from beyond the arc. The rebound by the Nets. Smooth's got 6 rebounds in the game.
The whole thing, boy.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
And Turner kicks to Parker. Double team on Parker. The pass to Mirotić. Just 5 to shoot. And just miss after miss right now.
For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. And so it looks like the Hawks will retain possession here. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out east already. We are in December. Taking a look at Brooklyn, earning the first place position with a terrific record. And we've seen them perform splendidly pretty much all season long so far, and they're definitely the team to beat. And, of course, there's the Hawks, just way behind.
And, you know, right now for Atlanta, they've shown me some very good things this season. But that next step, those qualities that could make them true contenders, just haven't been there.
Now, you just don't want to sit in the middle for too long. You either want to be competing against the top teams or starting to strategize where you can position yourself for a high lottery pick and maybe turn around your franchise's fortunes.
46 seconds left to play here in the first. Turner passes to Parker. And that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Well, Jabari got the defense to bite on that particular play, mostly because he was aggressive with it.
No good on the free throw. So for the Nets, Jay's checked in for Durant, and Prez is subbed in for Irving. Good on the second free throw. 34 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Smooth, and oh boy, a lot of contact there, but he gets the call and will shoot two. And this is his second trip to the line in the game.
And he buried a bunch of shots from the stripe in that last game.
And Brooklyn making a change here. Jordan's checked in.
And doing a good job getting to the line and capitalizing.
And it's Parker in the corner. Shot and game clock separated by five. And Mirotić has it in the corner. Misses the three. Here's Smooth. He has 45 points. Up in time. And that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. And so it's Brooklyn, enjoying the kind of gigantic lead you almost never see. From the field, they have been out. All right now. And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in a second. And guys, the Nets enjoying a nice lead here.
Well, credit their anticipation skills on the defensive end. They forced a number of turnovers.
Just playing some real gritty defense right now, just getting up in bodies and forcing a lot of turnovers.
This is how the floor looks for the Hawks starting the second quarter. Mirotić is out there with Jones. Then it's Evan Turner. Then there's Parker. And it's Reddish in at the two spot. Turner dishes to Parker. Pass to Jones. The Hawks working the ball around. Parker against James. Here's Turner. The rebound by the Nets.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good look.
Now just all alone down there. Credit goes to DeAndre for finding him. That's a nice pass.
And so it's Turner with it. He brings it up for the Atlanta Hawks. Well, last season for sure, Greg, a bit of a journey for DeAndre Jordan as he went from the Mavericks to the Knicks before his free agency. Now he is a part of Brooklyn.
And both KD and Kyrie took pay cuts to get Jordan on board. Still a factor with his size and defense, despite a lackluster year in 2019. Nets are hoping he can find his magic and be a force once again.
Oh, let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. It's been a pretty tough stretch for them.
And this will be an important possession. It's really essential they put a stop to this run, and the best way to do it is by great execution.
Back to Turner. Prez with the rebound.
That's not going to make you a favorite target of your teammates. They'll think twice about feeding you if you're going to keep missing layups.
Just playing with poise and confidence, and they continue to put points on the board.
Yeah, just really pouring it on right now, trying to take away the opposition's motivation to keep competing in this one.
Turner looking around. Down low. That's it. And here we go. Fast break. James has got it. And James throws it down hard.
At this point, I don't know what you can do to slow this team down.
Well, nothing that they're doing seems to be making an impact. And there are some nights where you just run out of options, whether it's by personnel or by tactic.
And powering it home, he ends a 12-0 run by the Nets.
And he says, right back at you with a big dunk of his own.
Look at the handles. Gets through the D and then powers it home.
Such a pretty move inside. Clark, how do you stop that? They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Mirotić, the pass to Parker. It's deflected. Out in his own on the break. Here's Smooth. And another one falls.
And he's been dominant here thus far.
Shouldering the offense, GA really taking it to the opposition. Poked away. Outside Turner. He kicks it to Jones. And here's Reddish. He's been quiet so far, still no points in the game. And Turner throws it down.
That's impressive for Turner to get up off of the deck so quickly there. Nice vertical shown on that dunk.
Really like that warfare in the paint. He has really established a low post presence.
And almost 4 minutes gone here in the second quarter of play. To the wing right side. Outside, Jones. Shot clock at 5. Kicks it to Reddish. On deep. Rebounded by the Nets. Jordan's got his 6th rebound on the night. Good, that's another bucket.
Make that 61 point.
Yep, everything is going his way right now.
I love the aggressiveness. He's been on fire the entire first half and continues to strike while the iron's hot.
Mirotić, the pass to Turner. It's through for a second basket. He's now 2 for 6.
This is where Turner impresses you with his strength, able to take a little bit of a hit before finishing.
And there's the foul. It goes on Evan Turner. That is his first foul of the game. Kevin Durant's checked in for the Nets. Kyrie Irving comes in for Smooth. Irving against Young. Irving, good.
I know Kyrie is not the biggest guy on the floor, but he is built and built to take that kind of contest.
And we have an intentional foul there, G.A. Wish I could say why.
That one's pretty strange. I mean, no idea what got into his head right there.
Smooth checked in for Kyrie Irving. Collins passes to Young. He gets that one. Young's got his 3rd bucket of the night.
A big man, John Collins, seeing the court that time.
Good, he hits again. He's been absolutely ridiculous in this game.
You get the sense he just can't miss.
Here's Young. 23 points for him the last game against Utah.
Yeah, but there's always this point, Kevin. You got to look at where did he also impact the game. It was on the rebounding end of the floor. A tremendous performance there.
And, guys, that's not as easy as he made it look. You've got to have some skills to pull that off.
Well, he's got plenty of those, yeah. That's for sure. And he could not get that one to go. Out of contact, and he'll go to the line for 2. It's on Kevin Durant.
Drawing a foul down low. Trae Young earning that trip to the line. It's really all about Trae Young and his skill. And you know how many hours that takes, Kevin? I mean, he is putting time in the gym to show you what he's capable of out here on this floor, and he makes it look easy.
I mean, it's just fun to sit back and enjoy watching him operate. And that's what it looked like the D was doing as well. They're just sitting back and watching.
And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Hey, Kevin. Well, the Hawks said they were going to be patient when they rebuilt their team, and they were going to do it through the draft, and they've stuck to that script. Now, Trae Young is probably the biggest name, but Atlanta's added a lot of great young talent the last 3 years. There's John Collins, Kevin Huerter, and in 2019, the Hawks added 3 more good young players in the draft. DeAndre Hunter, Cam Reddish, and Bruno Fernando. Things are looking up in Atlanta.
I would think so, too. On paper, it looks good. We'll see if it materializes. D.A., thank you as always. And Brent, for Trae Young, remarkable how his game has grown.
It's going to be interesting over the next 3 to 5 years what kind of layers Trae Young can add to his game. We know he is a prolific shooter. He's got deep range. He's a good playmaker. But how good does he want to be? We're going to find out how complete he can be.
To win with consistency, Brent, you need guys who you can bank on. Guys, you can count. With that in mind, who's the most consistent? You see night in and night out in the NBA.
Well, Kevin Durant and James Harden are just tremendous at scoring the basketball. Anywhere they are, at any time, they have an opportunity within a few minutes to explode and put 10 or 12 points on the board.
Oh, that was something else!
And how about just floating to the rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets up, I mean, he gets up! Atlanta's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Pass to Herter. Back to Young. Here's the triple. Here's Len. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. It's going to be on DeAndre Jordan.
Well, Alex Len, in the age of pace and space as a big, trying to find his way to be effective on both ends of the floor. He has that size and length. He brings that to the table every night.
Brooklyn making some changes. Allen comes in for Jordan. And Prez is subbed in for James. There he goes!
You don't want to be jumping on a play like that.
No.
Wow, he was up there, Kevin.
And the dunk was nice, Kevin, but the move he made to free himself up was a thing of beauty.
It sure was, Greg. What a savvy play to get into position for that jam. Back to Young. Lets it go from deep. Hits the three-point bomb. Young's got 17 now.
Feels like the other four guys have disappeared at this point. He wants to be the one to get them back.
Passes to Prez. Here's Magician, fires from deep. Here's Smooth, another one falls for Brooklyn.
He's played a huge role in this game to this point, but it looks like he just wants more. He wants to make sure that this lead holds up.
Goes up, and there's another. And there's 80 points.
Wow. Just wow. This guy right now on another level.
Atlanta's gone 1-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for them. And here we go. Brooklyn fast break.
Sweet.
Nets with a new shot clock. It's tipped.
Collins
comes over with the double team. And KD throws it down.
I like to see KD when he just elongates like that. Gets all the way up to the rim for an easy throwdown.
There's the pass to Len. Here's Young. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
A moment here to check out some numbers for Prez. Just an incredible month of basketball. He's putting up about 5 points a game, 12 assists, and 8 rebounds. They're loving how he's running the show here. His sensational passing really breathing life into their offense.
Something in the coach's playbook here where the schemes fire on all cylinders. When he is in the game, a great conduit for them offensively. He knows where everyone is at all times.
106 left in the second quarter. Young outside. Off target from outside.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Good on the triple.
Such a critical part of how their offense is going to flow. Things are only working when he seems to be on the floor.
Here's Smooth. And got it! Another basket.
And he's been dominant here thus far.
Shouldering the offense, GA really taking it to the opposition. 43 seconds left in the first half. Young taking his time here. Gets an open look and hits. Young's got 21.
This is a one-man show right now. He's on a mission to get him out of this hole.
Here's Smooth. And they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain it.
Atlanta making a switch here. Parker's checked in.
No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business at the line.
5 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Young from outside drills the three-pointer. Young's got a pair of triples in the second now for Atlanta.
Yeah, he couldn't connect on anything from outside in the first quarter, but now he's hit 2 threes in the second quarter, and he looks much better.
Here's Smooth. 1 second left, and the last shot before the buzzer is off.
He's very engaged right now, John Collins, defensively, and that's starting to make a difference for the team.
And so it's the Brooklyn Nets, able to put on a show for the ages. And it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. Right back after this break.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show. Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Okay.
It was a fast pace for Brooklyn at the outset. They opened up the game knocking down shots and defending extremely well, going on a blazing 15-2 run. They came on extremely strong as the quarter was winding down, nailing all six of their last field goal attempts to close out the first. Then in quarter number two, it was all hands on deck, and what a show it was. Quality execution, good efficiency, some tremendous defensive play helped them take a decisive advantage, and they're running away with this one. And from what we saw so far from the Nets, Kenny, what's your takeaway?
They have run their offense straight out of a coach's textbook tonight. Both ball and player movement have been excellent. And the result of all that movement, almost all high-quality shots they're generating. It's pretty to watch. Very good fundamental basketball.
And Shaq, what'd you see from Atlanta?
Ernie, I don't use this word a lot because, one, I can't spell it, but it was definitely a subpar effort for them on the glass. That hurt. They're serious about cutting into this deficit. It's gut check time. Ugh. You hear that, Ernie? I'm hitting my gut. Ugh. You got to check your gut, Ernie. Ugh. Gut check time, Ernie.
And that should do it. With the second half about to begin, let's send you back to Kevin Harlan. Go back. Kevin Harlan. Go. Go over there.
Wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. What a game we're seeing from Smooth.
Well, it didn't take him long to get that double-double. Already has it halfway through the game.
Yeah, guys like him love to stuff the stat sheet. He's doing it here.
We've got Trez out there with Smooth. Then it's Jordan, and it's James in at the three slot. That's the group starting the second half for Kenny Atkinson. Here's Young. The rejection by James. In transition, here come the Nets. And he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Here he comes, and there he goes.
Oh, look at him punish that rim. Pass to Hunter. One kicks to Hunter. Can't hit that one. And it's the Nets taking it the other way. Here's Smooth. And the Nets, another three.
The assist totals, Kevin, just continue to grow. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been flawless.
Here's Len. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. Now the shot clock resets to 14 seconds on an offensive rebound. Brent, do you like that change?
I think digging into the numbers a little bit, Kevin, it only affects about 3% of total possessions.
Is that all?
Yeah, throughout the course of the year. Not in any given game. So it's very, very...
No kidding.
Very, very minimal what happens. But what I like is that... You know, players have to reset quickly with 14 on the clock. And I think coaches are starting to think about how it is they might have quick sets as opposed to getting the ball to the top of the key and trying to run through a traditional set. Maybe you have quick sets after the reset to get yourself a better shot.
More strategy.
They have a good plan going right now, and they're starting to create separation.
Well, game plan might have been good, but you have to bring it together. Right now, their chemistry is something to be admired.
Pass to Herter. Just over a minute and a half have passed here in the third quarter. Young, good look. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
You talk about things at halftime, and then you come out and you go 0 for 3.
Oh!
Caution. Flammable.
That is just nasty.
About the athleticism on that finish. And everything is dropping for them. Terrific second half run.
Well, with the confidence growing, that's one thing, but they seem to be getting more intense, and that's helping the quality of their play here.
Poked loose in the corner. Herter with it. And the three ball is good.
All right. After four misses, they finally get one to go. That has to be a big relief for the offense after beginning this half on a bit of a cold streak.
Another bucket. Wow. He's been absolutely ridiculous in this game.
You get the sense he just can't miss.
Here's Smooth.
That's a great dunk.
Breaker.
And overboard.
Wow.
Yeah, letting it rip. They're just having fun right now.
Yeah, some of these nights you gotta enjoy yourself. Not too much at the expense of the other team, but right now this team is balling.
Balling like Curry.
Young left side. Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game.
He has created some terrific opportunities for himself and really made the most of them.
Young for 3, connects from 3-point range. Young's got 27.
Well, he's 1 for 5 in the quarter, and his body language is saying a lot about where his confidence is. Rattled just a little bit. Maybe the next open look will start him up.
Look, if I'm leaving, I'm hitting it.
Gone 2 of 7 from the field in the third. That leaves room for improvement, certainly. Another 3 for Atlanta.
Their 3-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
All sorts of time. They get the rebound.
I'm sorry, that's poor defense. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. The baseline, Jay. The rebound by the Nets. Jay's got it. Got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
He's going, bro.
Collins draws the miss.
No, I'm not leaving. No.
Now, here's Hunter. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Young from outside buries the long-range jumper.
The defense a step slow, and you can see the result.
Brooklyn's gone 3 of 6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Smooth, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. Some great shooters here. Let's check out the league leaders. Well, you look at Smooth, leading the league in field goal percentage. He always gets good looks.
He is a finisher, plain and simple. That field goal percentage just absolutely jumps out at you. It borders on astonishing.
Looking at who's out there now for the Nets. Jared Allen's checked in for Jordan.
Durant
comes in for Jay. Spencer Dinwiddie's checked in for James. And Irving subbed in for Prez. Torian Prince. An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose, Greg? I'm not sure.
It's a scene of confusion right there. I can't imagine why he thought it was a good idea to foul there.
Reddish kicks to Young. Mirotić with it. He's making his presence felt offensively with his scoring average up there at almost 13 points a game.
Someone's open. Trae Young scanning and finds him.
Corner shot.
I'm hitting me.
Mirotić brings the double team. Here's Smooth. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
With the finish line in sight, this guy is determined to be the one to put the game away.
Some changes for Brooklyn. Jordan, he's checked in for Allen. Jay comes in for Kevin Durant. And James subbed in for Torian Prince. And the Hawks making a change here as well. Parker's checked in for Trae Young. Now Turner. He's got 6. Parker inside. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
Parker doing a good job of moving his body and playing with pace. He's making the defense get a bit too handsy down there.
And here's Brooklyn. Next step for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. And that game is the second of 2 straight at home.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Here's Smooth. Hits it again. Wow. He's been absolutely ridiculous in this game.
You get the sense he just can't miss.
The Hawks have gone just a bit under 50% from the field since halftime. 5 out of 11. Here's Turner. Sweet little floater. Turner's got 8 points.
Good control there from Evan Turner. He has the ball on the string. It's nice handles from the small forward.
And the call will be against Damian Jones. That's his first foul. So it's Brooklyn now. Here's Smooth. Here's Jimmy.
Oh, this is a good... Oh, my God.
Here's Smooth. Kept alive.
Oh, 2K.
Shoot again. Here's Prez. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
And just no excuse, guys, for leaving a shooter like him open beyond the arc.
And here is Turner. He's got 8. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his 5th make on 9 shots from the floor.
He's been terrific tonight, and with a little help from the other guys on the floor, they might be able to turn this game around.
The
pass to Smooth. Lets it go from 11, and it goes down 2 points.
Perfect approach for what the D was showing on that possession.
Hawks have gone 7 of 13 in the third quarter so far, just above 50%. And he goes in for the dunk.
As athletic a move as you're going to see right there. Unreal.
How about the hang time on that thing? Wow. And so it's Turner with it. He brings it up for Atlanta. He kicks to Reddish. Outside, Jones. The Hawks working the ball around. The shot by Turner, no good. And here are the Nets. They're on a 16-7 run.
And after spending his first NBA decade with the Clippers, DeAndre Jordan bounced around last season. Remains a supreme athlete and rebounder, though, at that center position.
Turner passes to Mirotić. Here's Turner. 10 points for him. Double team on Parker. 6 to shoot.
And it's blocked.
In transition, here come the Nets.
Changing ends quickly, getting the advantage in numbers and finishing. They've been doing it all night long.
Yeah, their energy level's been amazing. Battery bar still full, hustling and still working hard out there.
Turner dishes to Parker. Back to Turner. Gets that one to fall. That's his 6th field goal. He has shot the ball 12 times. And a nightly double-double threat is DeAndre Jordan. But some dissatisfaction with his play last season. Great was that?
Well, I felt like his impact has tailed off just a bit from his peak with the Clippers. Sometimes the great athletes have more of an adjustment as they enter the 30s.
The shot by Turner, no good.
How about the timing he shows there to challenge that shot?
Yeah, not easy to do there, and that's a guy that you can tell takes every possession defensively very seriously.
I tell you what, he was on a mission on that possession. Did not stop working until he got it up and in.
To the right side. Mirotić has a wide open look. Another 3 for Atlanta.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Maybe trying to find a little bit more space and ball movement to get guys open at the 3-point line.
Down the 3-ball.
And one of the stories of the second half has been all of those second chance points. I mean, they have been terrific on the offensive backboard.
And Turner kicks to Mirotić. Pass to Reddish. From the high post, Jordan with the rebound. Jordan's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort. Smooth. There's the killer 2-minute slam.
All night they've asked him to shoulder the scoring load, and he is not disappointed.
And for the Hawks, they're shooting just 39% from the field, struggling to find that net. Now, here's Parker. On the wing, Turner. The tray. No good on that one. And so it's the Brooklyn Nets with a huge lead at the break. Safe to say, there's no catching them today. And they've created a bunch of turnovers with that terrific D. Back to the action after this word. Here now a chance to show you our assist of the game, and it's presented as always by State Farm.
And how about the floor generalship right here? I mean, showing us why they're always in good hands when he's the man in charge.
Great hands, great vision. That makes great things happen for your offense.
One quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. Timeout called, the Nets. And how often do players argue calls knowing that they are in the wrong? They know they're going after something that was the correct call.
Let's just say often, Kevin. I mean, we just never, the whistle.
Are they thinking ahead in terms of saying?
I don't think so. It's emotional. It's just an emotional reaction. I mean, you're out there running around and doing what you do, and you get a whistle, you're going to react to like, oh, I did something wrong. Why am I in the principal's office right now? I want to get my side out. I know you saw it. Everybody does.
That sounds like you may have done a lot of that.
I tried to avoid that, Kevin.
Did you?
Oh, yeah. I don't think that's healthy for you and your reputation.
And now a moment to check out the winners in the All-Star voting. Balloting underway.
And this is really a fun time of year. You're starting to see which players are going to be in the running to make the All-Star team.
Well, you look at Smooth. Right now he leads in the East, getting plenty of balance with his name on.
And as much of an honor as it is to make the team, finishing number one, I think it's just that much bigger.
And keep tuning in for updated results. You can visit NBA.com for more. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. And so in the game for the Hawks, Bembry out there with Chandler Parsons. Then it's Jones. Then it's Turner. And it's Crabb in at the two-guard position. Knocked away. Outside Turner. Pass to Crabb. For so long, the U.S. has been the country to beat in international basketball play. But there are some big-time challengers around the globe emerging.
Well, Serbia and Spain continue to be competition that the U.S. takes extremely seriously. And I'm not saying they don't take everybody that they step on the floor against with tremendous amount of respect. We know from years in the past that Argentina had its golden age with the players around Manu Ginobili and Oberto and Nocioni, but that seemed to be a timing thing for the Argentinian national team. Spain and Serbia will continue to be impressive and continue to push USA basketball in these international tournaments and Olympic play.
Here's Smooth. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Collins checked in for the Hawks. Young comes in for Evan Turner.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Now here's Parsons. Defense right on him. The Hawks working the ball around. Crabb with the ball. It's stolen by Prez. Oh, and a fast break for the Nets. It's good. Smooth's got 9 points now in the quarter. Now Crabb. Nabbing another steal.
And you got to be careful around him.
No, Greg, he's been coming up with some incredible steals so far.
Oh, he is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
Well, that could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think. And Young kicks the Crabb. Back to Young. To stop the run, he takes it up and lays it in. Young's got 35.
He makes it look effortless out there. Until the defense actually presents a challenge for him, expect those kind of results.
And that one drops for him.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
Up and in on the layup. Young's got 37.
Yeah, Trae Young showing you variety. He can score in a lot of ways.
Here's Smooth. And he jams it with authority.
Boone just shook his man loose with a craft play inside.
And then the dunk just tops it off beautifully. Atlanta's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Parsons passes to Young. Here's the three. Good on the three-point shot. He has 40.
You really got to tip your cap to him in terms of how he's played today, even if they end up losing this game.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. Brent, we're talking about home court advantage. Do you feel it's the same as it used to be? It has that same impact.
I do think it's still hugely important, Kevin. It's less important when there's a team that has been together for a long time and proven that they can take their wares on the road and come home with a victory, but it absolutely gives you a level of comfort as a player to get into your routine, to be at a place that seems familiar. Something deep down psychologically helps every member of that team being at home.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
And the gamble paying off.
All alone, and he hits the jump shot. Young's got 42 in the game.
I mean, the stroke looks good. He's moving well out there. What a sensational start to this game. Perfect from the field.
And it's blocked. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Parsons. Now a timeout call by Brooklyn. Checked in for Jared Allen. Jay comes in for Wilson Chandler. James checked in for Torian Prince. And Prez is up in for Spencer Dinwiddie.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Another steal. Unhindered, going all the way.
My goodness, that was absolutely filthy.
Nasty. This building is stunned. He dug deep, Greg, into his bag of tricks there. And so Young will bring it up for Atlanta. They can look forward to the Cavaliers after this game in a matchup against Cleveland. That will conclude their brief two-game road trip. Wide open, couldn't capitalize. Brooklyn's gone 5 of 10 from downtown tonight. 50% exactly.
And really the story of this second half. One team getting the shots they want. The other, not so much.
Yeah, this team did something in halftime, going from a mild-mannered half-court executing team to some heroic shooting in the second half. This whole second half, he's been unbelievable scoring the basketball. The defense has had literally no effect.
And here is Crabb. It's tough to get a unified feel on who the league MVP is. Which element, when you're looking at the MVP, matters most to you?
If we talk about that, Kevin, I always think about the MVP ends up being the guy that helps you get 6 to 8 unexpected wins. That's who I look to. So in this past season, what it was that Giannis did, not only with Coach Budenholzer coming in to Milwaukee, the stylistic change that they went through, and then the shouldered responsibility of Giannis to be the initiator to that much change in one season. That's why last year I feel like he was the most valuable player in the league. Even though eye-popping numbers were coming out of Houston again with James Harden, I go back to Giannis and that massive amount of change and him being the guy that shouldered it all.
That's a great answer. The three. Drills it from outside.
He's a decent passer at his position, DeAndre Jordan, with a solid understanding of what happens on that play and how he can keep players involved.
Another steal. In transition, here come the Nets. Here's Smooth. Yet another bucket.
And this game has his name written all over it.
Greg, he's been phenomenal in offensive onslaught. Young outside. Can they get it? Brooklyn with the rebound.
And they just can't find a way to end this thing. Nothing's falling right now.
Frustration seems to be mounting here, and you can see not just in their faces, but right now in their quick and hurried shot selection.
Here's Young. Takes the three. And once again off the mark by Atlanta.
Well, the D really getting away with one there. No one on him. And that's going to be good.
Most players would give anything for that kind of vertical.
But he's not giving it away. He wants to keep it all for himself.
Maybe we should call the maintenance crew. He's trying to tear the rim off.
Not just a scorer. Like how unselfish Parsons can be with the ball.
Here's Smooth.
Bro, here's James. I can't hit that shot. Are you kidding me, bro?
Here's Smooth. And another shot.
Good
work there as it goes. James got his first points of the night.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Young passes to Parsons. Young inside. Brooklyn with the rebound. James has got rebound number 8 here tonight in the game. Here's Smooth.
Oh.
And that one is hammered home.
Oh, that's an old-fashioned rim wrapper.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now. Here's Crabb. Young finds Crabb. And Young, here we go, takes it off the glass. Young's got 47 points.
You just can't take Trae Young lightly from anywhere on the floor. These kind of shots will help him get into a rhythm.
Smooth passes to James. Fires from 18. Again, the Nets for 2.
And yeah, he's not messing around. He wants no part of a comeback in this one.
Well, he's grabbed a tee and a blanket because he's putting this one to bed.
Here's Young. And it's good for 2. Young's got 49 points in the game.
An extremely efficient and productive game for him. But again, he's not going to be able to do it all by himself. Well, he's been doing it all night. Why not go back to him?
Yeah, he's feeling it. Keep feeding him until he misses.
Len, and the dunk by Len.
Yeah, you're not going to fool around much on the interior, especially if you're Alex Len, that big, that close. Easy bucket.
Outside Jordan. From past the arc.
You can't shoot
threes. But they recover.
My boy. I put three.
And they double up Jordan. Goes up and lays it nice and easy.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance. And it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Nets.
Nothing like second chance buckets to pick up the scoring pace.
Yeah, it was impressive how they piled on the extra points, hitting the offensive glass, and then also winning the 50-50 ball battle.
And so it'll boost this year's win total for them to 29.
And once the horn sounds, they're going to go up 2-0 in the season series.
And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Smooth.
Well, the tone was set by him defensively tonight, recorded a number of blocks, and that was a big difference maker, intimidating the other team.
Passes it to Crabb. There's 45 seconds left in the game. 6 on the shot clock. Young's shot is off. And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Nets.
Making every effort to put this game on ice.
Loved it. The guys are staying aggressive late in this ball game, just not wanting to let go of the rope.
And another steal for him.
And he's just been able to anticipate their every move.
Yeah, you're right. An absolute pest on the defensive end.
Impressive job by the players, coaches, and don't discount the impact of these fans.
Awesome to see their output tonight, trying to urge their team on, and that can always help. That home advantage of home fans getting you going fully on display here.
Lynn, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
You've got to be more cautious when you're guarding Alex Lynn. Obviously, his size puts you at an